Hello all, welcome back to my YouTube channel Embedbits&bytes. Today we are going to learn about the system bus. So by now you know that the processor fetches instruction from memory, process it and sends it back to the IO system and again fetches data, computes it, and this cycle goes on and on and on. So what is the medium of transfer of all this information between the CPU and memory and between the CPU and IO peripherals? They are the buses. A bus is a set of lines that carry data between these various components. There are three types of buses classified based on their functionalities: address bus, data bus, and system and control bus. The address bus will carry the address from processor to memory. The data bus carries the data to that particular address. The processor can either read or write data from the memory. The control bus will mention the action to be carried out, that is either to read or to write. Width or size of a bus. A single line bus will carry one bit of data. A single line can carry either a 0 or a 1. So it can either turn a transistor high or low. Only an electronic switch like transistor can switch between VCC and ground at the speed of gigahertz to transfer the bits of data. If the transistor base is connected to VCC, it's a high. If it is grounded, it's a 0. This is how millions and millions of data are being transferred inside any device. So the data can be the data of music or audio, video, images or anything. So to us it is a text data or an image data or a video data. But to the computer it is only zeros and ones. A two-line bus can carry 2 bits of data. A 4-line bus can carry 4 bits of data at a time. An 8-line bus can carry 8 bits of data at a time, and likewise. So more the lines, more the information can be transferred based on their size. And based on the size, that is the number of lines, we name the buses. If it has 8 lines, it's an 8-bit address bus. If it has 16 lines, it's a 16-bit address bus, and so on. So what is the relationship between the size of a bus and the memory? The size of the memory is exponentially proportional to the size of the bus. There are 2 power n number of address locations in memory, where n is the size of your address bus. If it's a 2-bit address bus, there are 4 address locations. There can be 4 different combinations of zeros and ones in a 2-bit address bus. It can be either 00, 01, 10 or 11. Similarly, a 3-bit address bus can have 8 different address locations or the 8 different combinations. Each address needs to have a unique number. So that's why 000, 001, 010, 011, 100, 101, 110 and 111 if it's a 3-bit address bus. So if it's a 8-bit address bus, there are 2 power 8 address location, that is 256. The 16-bit address bus, we will have 65,535 memory address locations. And so the size of the memory is optimized to 64 KB. Let's learn the working of the system bus with an example. So on the table you can see the representation of the memory. On the left you have the address and on the right the data corresponding to that particular address. Now at location 4000 we have the data 35. The processor wants to replace it by 25. So the processor wants to send the data 25 and store it at location 4000. So which bus will first come into the picture? Correct. The address bus. because we need to know the address where we want to send the data to. Sending the data first will go to some random location and it might corrupt the whole data that is already present there. So we need to identify the location that we need to operate on. V over here is the processor. The address bus will carry the location details, that is 4000, and send it to the memory. So all the locations in the memory, the processor will now focus on this particular location, that is 4000. Next comes the data bus. The processor will send the value 25 to the data bus. Is the job of the processor done by now? No. It's still got one final step to tell what should be done with the data, either to read or write. When the processor fetches the data, it is a read operation. And when the processor sends the data, it is a write operation. Here we want to replace 35 by 25. So it is a write operation. We are giving the data 25 to the memory. So it is a write operation. So this is how every bit gets stored in the memory. And you will be amazed by the speed at which it happens. So when you complete writing a Word document and save the whole file, after you click the save button, you can imagine that this is what happens in the background. It is just one operation happening millions of times at different locations with different data. Just one more example and we are done with this video. Next, the processor wants to know the data that is present in the location 4002. So first, the processor will send the address 4002. Via the address bus. So the memory location will get selected. Now is the catch. Which comes next? The data bus or the control bus? Correct. The control bus. The control bus will carry the instruction of the operation to be performed, and here it is a read operation. The data bus will then fetch the data 85 and transmit to the processor. There is a subtle difference between the read and the write operation. When the processor is writing a data to the memory, the processor knows what data it is going to write. So data bus comes first. During read operation, the processor knows only the address, not the data. So the control bus comes first to transmit the control signal, and then the data bus will fetch the data. I hope this is clear for you all. So with this, the video comes to an end. Thank you all for watching the video. Please do like, share, and subscribe to my channel for more videos. Thank you.